Hi, it's Giffen Lobates here, and this is video 16 in a series commissioned by the Helsinki Blockchain Center. And today's question is, can a blockchain be hacked? And that is a surprisingly complicated question. However, I'm going to start by giving a very simple answer. And the answer is, yes, a blockchain can be hacked because blockchains are written in software, and anything more complicated than one line of code is probably going to contain some bugs. So given the number of lines of software that are involved in producing a blockchain, it's pretty certain that there will be bugs in there that will allow a hacker to do something that the designers of the system don't want to have happen. And that allows us to drill down into one of the problems with the question, can X be hacked? And that is, what do we mean by hacked? There are hacks that are very, very serious. For example, in the blockchain world, a hack where an attacker can write arbitrary transactions or transfer anyone's coins, that would be a very serious hack. A less serious hack might be something that is just an inconvenience, something that doesn't actually steal people's funds or completely snarl up the system, but that is something that's a bit undesirable, for example, slowing down the number of transactions that can be handled or something like that. So that general question has to be focused in on something more specific in order to be able to answer it properly. But I think as a final note, what I'd like to say is we have a number of layers to look at in a blockchain system when we talk about, has the system been hacked or not, and where has the hack occurred. So you have the blockchain system at the bottom, which is kind of like an operating system. And there have been incidences in the past where hacks have happened. In Bitcoin, the oldest blockchain, there were a number of upsets in the early days, but it was just being tried and tested. Since those initial upsets, it's been pretty solid. The most solid piece of software that I have seen in a long, long time, to be honest. The next level up, we have things such as smart contracts, which are running on top of blockchains. Now, we see lots of hacks in that space. I don't think a month goes by without there being a report of a smart contract being drained of its funds because it wasn't coded properly. So although the system is rock solid, or not rock solid, but almost rock solid, the implementations that people put on top of it are often flawed. And this is because smart contracting programming is not simple. And we live in a world where the programming paradigm is release early, release often, break things, and then fix them. And you can't do that in the smart contract programming world. You do have some patterns that allow you to redeploy contracts when you find bugs, but generally speaking, writing software for smart contracts is a bit like writing software for space missions, where you can't do anything about it once it's out there in space. So then the third thing we have is interfaces, where the blockchain world connects to the human world, and that area has been rife with problems. There are so many examples of exchanges being hacked, and it's that interface between the blockchain and the outside world, and it tends to be the outside world that has the flaws and the problems. And again, that boils down to the problem that I talked about with smart contracts, that the programming paradigm we have is not focused on security, it's focused on business and marketing, and as a result, we're moving too quickly and things go wrong. I've got some other videos on my channel where I talk about this difficulty between security and business, and you can go and look them up on my channel if you want to. In the meantime, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video soon. Bye for now.